Cole, I'm the director of Bob Bartleson Music School. And on behalf of everyone here at the school, I'm very pleased to welcome you to tonight's senior recital, graduation recital, by one of our favorites, Richard Ackerman. This is being recorded, but we ask that you put your cell phones on stun or silent operating mode or switch them off. And while the performers may remove their masks, we ask that you all keep yours on in the audience just to make things a little bit safer. And without further ado, would you please welcome to the stage Richard Ackerman.
Thank you so much for coming. I'm really glad we can gather for concerts again. Really cool. So the way I structured the program tonight is, if you look at your programs, look at the dates of the composers, they're all chronological. So I did this for a reason. So I really love classical music, and I wanted to play a piece from each era of classical music. So generally, when we talk about classical music, we're actually referring to three distinct eras: Baroque, classical, and romantic. And then after that comes like modern music, but I'm not playing any of that. I'm playing at least one piece from each era and a few in between. So the first one that I'm playing is a piece by Johann Sebastian Bach from the Baroque era. And a major characteristic of Baroque music is what's called counterpoint, different voices interweaving. And because Bach is such a genius, he knows how to make it sound like there are multiple voices, even when there's only one instrument. So I'll be playing the Bach C major cello suite, first two movements, and I'll be playing on viola, because viola has the same register, just not too high. Thank you. from the classical era. It's by Carl Stamitz. He was alive around the same time as Mozart and Haydn, so it sounds kind of similar. So one characteristic of the classical era is it's very formal, very structured, and a lot of attention on the melody. So I want to thank my accompanist, Tomoko, for playing with me. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. So my next piece is by Beethoven. Now, it's debated whether Beethoven counts as more classical or romantic. Let's just say he's in between. And so you'll see the structure sort of start to break down a bit. So Beethoven was known for being very creative with the types of harmonies, chords, and dynamics that he used. And I'll be playing this as a duet with Peter Seidenberg, who's a cello teacher, and was the coach for my quartet for several years. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
So you'll notice quite a bit of that in this piece. So I'm playing the Brahms Sonata in F minor for viola. Some people say it was originally written for clarinet, but come on, violists need something. So, yeah, I'll bring that with the vocal again. So yeah, let me just check the tune. Thank you. Some people call it impressionistic era, and this is by Rebecca Clark.
Thank you.
want to thank everyone who made this possible. A big thank you to my teacher, Ms. Klinger, over there. There you are. And I have a few gifts. This is for you, Ms. Klinger. Thank you so much. And this is for Mr. Seidenberg. Hosting the quartet even during the pandemic at his house and helping me progress in the years as a musician, so thank you. I want to thank all of Hof, especially Ken Cole, director, for allowing me to grow as a musician and stuff. And of course, again, thank Tomoko and the company. My dad, who put in so many hours to help me prepare. And my mom, of course, both my parents. I'm sorry, I didn't forget your mom. I mentioned dad because I'm playing an encore with him right now. It's a short fun piece, don't worry. But yeah, playing a little encore. This piece is called Chardish. It's a traditional gypsy tune that a lot of violinists play. So, you just play this.
Before we play, I just thought I should say a few words about, since we left Richard's bio out of the program, so I figured I would just say a few words about Richard's history here at Hof and what Hof Bartleson has meant to Richard and our family. I mean, it's been basically a second home to Richard. Since first grade, he's been coming here between viola lessons and chamber music and all kinds of ensembles and music theory and composition and summer festival. It's been a huge part of his life. I mean, so I can't thank enough the whole Hof Bartleson community for supporting Richard, his career here. And we'll definitely miss this place a lot. It's just coming here 3-4 days a week for so many years. Richard, as you know, he's in addition to music, he's was awarded as Eagle Scout a few weeks ago. And by the way, it's Boy Scout's fault that he was never in festival orchestra, because it means Tuesday night's the same day as, and I'm sorry, festival, but Scouts came a bit before festival orchestra. Richard's, besides here, he's been at many music festivals in Oberlin and at St. Paul and Kinhaven. And Richard is looking forward to his next year at Southern Methodist University in Dallas, Texas, where he'll be doing a double degree in viola and applied mathematics. So we look forward to that. And this, you know, I'm sure I'll play with Richard in the future sometime, but this is like a nice swan song for me to, all the years I've accompanied him and attempted to play some of these pieces that Tomoko thankfully was able to play today. So, with that, let's hear a little gypsy music. Thank you.
Has successfully completed the prescribed course of study, performed effectively in solo works from each significant period of music literature, fulfilled the requirements of the honors program, and is awarded this certificate in recognition of that achievement.
Pleasant Lane, you don't already know where that is. We have plenty of food if you're hungry.